Let's now get the perspective of a top political analyst on these latest developments in the 2022 race. Professor Edmund Tayao of the Ateneo School of Government now joins us. Professor Tayao is also the executive director of the Local Government Development Foundation. Professor, good afternoon to you. Thanks for joining us today.
Good afternoon, Carmina.
All right, so let's go ahead with the discussion. It's not infighting. There is no squabble. But you have two key allies of the mayor leaving HQ in the past couple of days. What's happening in the headquarters of the Manila mayor? How troublesome is this for him? How worrisome is it for the candidate, Professor?
You know, Carmina, we can expect this not only within the team of Mayor Isko, but even with the other candidates. It's just normal and expected to have differences within the party or within the group. Now, as far as the decision of individual candidates to reconsider, you know, their earlier bid, well, of course, again, it may have something to do with the limitations of the group of Mayor Isko. But it could also be the individual decision of the candidate. Alam mo kasi, Carmina, as you know, the kind of politics that we have is, you know, everything is dependent on the personality, no? Mm-hmm. Dependent on the candidate himself and dependent on the key candidate that one is allied with. So kung tatakbo kang senador and you're allied with the presidential contender, the presidential contender should be able to at the very least, no, contribute significantly to the cost of your campaign. Kasi we don't have real political parties, Carmina. So there are real considerations to be made as far as individual candidates are concerned. So we can only surmise that perhaps apart from individual differences within the team of Mayor Isko, there may probably also some considerations when it comes to funding.
That this is happening as well this early. And also, I have to point out, Professor Tayao, that, of course, we were just talking about two personalities here, Cesar Chavez's former chief of staff and also former Vice President Noli De Castro. But some people have also been adding the name of Congresswoman Vilma Santos into the mix. The fact that her candidacy under his slate did not push through. Many are pointing to that as sort of portentous of what had happened in the past couple of days, Professor.
You know, if the other candidates or the other candidates have a full slate on at the very start, then I wouldn't really consider this as common to all the candidates. But the fact that it's not only Mayor Isko, but even all the presidential candidates, if I'm not mistaken, don't have a complete slate. Some are even running without a vice president. So in other words, it's, overreaching to consider that there's really a big problem, you know, within the camp of Mayor Isko. Perhaps, again, as I've been saying, alam mo, any big organization, and I have to say the political group of Mayor Isko seem to be the biggest political group now. All of those that seem to have not found their places earlier on, no, have now found themselves with the group of Mayor Isko. So halo sila doon, no? There are so many old names identified with Mayor Isko, and there are also new names with Mayor Isko, and so it's really bound to require, no, substantial organizing skills to keep them, towing the same line. So let's see. I don't know if this will also play out with the other candidates, no. But I suppose hindi masyadong matitinig yung sa ibang kandidato, but the fact remains that all the candidates don't have a complete slate.
Mm-hmm. That this happened this early, is this sort of as part of what is expected in the early days of this season, or do you think that this is sort of a glimpse already into how his organization, his quarters will be in the run-up to the elections? What do you think about that?
again, Carmina, no, I don't want to be overreaching because, as I've said, if the other candidates have a complete slate already and this is happening only to Mayor Isko, or at the very least happening only to two candidates, then we can very well say that there's something wrong with the organization. The point is, it's already a given that given the kind of politics that we have, which is literally lacking an institutional kind of system, everything depends on the personality. So it's bound to happen. So we can say, of course, it somehow gives us a peek of the kind of leadership that Mayor Isko will provide or can provide with us. But having said that, it can also be considered that at this early, they can already make some adjustments.
When you talk about what's happening in the camp of Mayor Isko Moreno, and then you talk about, you know, that this is a problem not exclusive to him. But when you look at the other camps, Professor, they're talking about consolidating. Here you have people leaving HQ. So it's not the same.
Yeah, you know, you could say that, Carmina, but it also shows the comparative size of the different groups. Again, as I said, no, you can very well identify so many groups found within the group of Mayor Isko, because you know, perhaps there's a reason why they've been presenting themselves as not necessarily an anti-Duterte group, nor is it a pro previous administration group. So, in other words, unifying candidate, that's how they would like themselves called, no? The other candidates, of course, would like to consolidate precisely because they want to increase their numbers, they want to increase their reach. So, yeah, you're right, no? It's an entirely different context, so to speak. But one thing is common with all the other candidates. Something's really wrong with the kind of politics that we have. And until such time that we can veer away and change this personality-oriented politics, we will always be experiencing this kind of developments.
So let's talk about the other contenders now. We talked about the consolidation. And when you talk about consolidation, people are talking about now Vice President Leni Robredo and her continuing bid to consolidate a true united opposition. Do you think it's still possible at this point?
When you say united opposition, Carmina, and our idea of opposition is any candidate that's not identified with the administration or does not identify with the administration, with that definition, I don't think there can be something that could be done to still unify them, because it's like saying you're going to consolidate the group of Senator Ping and Senator Soto, Mayor Isko, no, and Senator Manny Pacquiao. They've gone through a series of talks, and everyone has heard of those reports, and nothing came out of it. So one is, in fact, no, up to now, blaming the other for the failure of, you know, having a common candidate. Again, this has something to do with the system, because, again, it's not the political parties that actually decide who gets to run. It's the personality himself who decides or who gets to make the final say as to whether he or she is going to run.
Hmm. Let's talk about Vice President Leni and the left. What are your thoughts about that? People now talking about why the vice president has yet to include Nery Colmenares, for example, in her slate. How important, or is it important, for the left to be allied with the Vice President Leni Robredo at this point?
It would really be a plus, no, for the vice president to have them on her side.
In the same vein,
in the same vein that the left would have the advantage of having Vice President Robledo on their side, because each would gain allies, no, in the process. Again, we have to consider significantly that we have this several months more, no, paying out to the May elections, and that there's really a need to, as you've said, consolidate and really organize, no, the different political groups vying for office. So this will definitely be to their advantage. It will add numbers to them, and it will beef up their machinery with whatever it is that they already have.
Why is this an argument solely for the vice president and the left? Why can't we talk about the left and Senator Pacquiao, for example, the left and Senator Ping Lacson, together with Senate President Vicente Soto III, and even with Manila Mayor Isko Moreno, who is widely believed to be supported by the left?
You know, Carmina, so much have already happened in the past, not only 6 years, but in the past several administrations. And we've seen the many instances that the government has tried to negotiate with the left, starting, not only starting with then democracy icon, the late President Cory Aquino. And we know already what happened, no? In regard to with this, our negotiations with the Moro rebels, we are already in the far advanced stage. In the case of the left rebels, the leftist rebels, we have not even gone to square one, no? So, in other words, if you're a candidate and you're going to weigh your options, you would not want to be really identified with the left. Perhaps that's one reason why. And this is the very reason also why, if you are going to understand the way the vice president has been extending cooperative gestures to the left, is to really defining that this is the democratic left groups, no, and not the leftist organizations that have critical relationships, no, with the armed groups. So if there's any reason for it, well, perhaps it's only Vice President Lenny who considers, no, the value of working with the left-oriented organizations.
Nothing prevents the left, these organizations, to declare their support, right, for Vice President Lenny Robredo.
Yeah, but again, I don't think it's the left that started the negotiations. So the way I understand the news, if my sources are right, or if the news that I've happened to read is accurate, it's the vice president that extended, you know, the discussion with the leftist organizations. Of course, the left would definitely have their right. In fact, it is their tactical or strategic advantage, not to be the one deciding who to be allied with. But they themselves are also being careful in this regard. Again, this election really is proving to be very unique, and they would really want to make sure that they will regain so much lost footing, precisely because of the sustained attacks on the the way the people see the left-oriented groups.
Would it be advantageous for the vice president if some leftist or progressive groups at this point just declare it to the public that they are supportive, if they are, of the vice president, and not really maintain the discussion behind the scenes?
You know, Carmina, I don't think they're doing it behind the scenes, and I don't think it prevents anyone from declaring they're supporting whoever, no, whether he's supporting Mario or Pedro or Juan or whoever, except that they have to, again, because this is politics and you're talking about alliances, you don't want to be saying, I'm going to marry Maria without Maria knowing that she's being married. They have to talk first, and that's how they are trying to make the people understand. We are discussing it. We are considering options. And when we're able to find an agreement, then we will announce some kind of alliance or partnership. Meanwhile, of course, they can very well declare not that they're supporting this particular candidate. But again, the way of politics is you have to find some kind of agreement first, before you can formally announce a partnership.
Okay, we're going to have to leave it at that. We've run out of time. It was great talking to you again, Professor Edmund Tayo of the Ateneo School of Government.
Thank you.
You take care. Keep safe.
Thank you, Carmina.